Hello, and welcome back to Creative Imagineering. I hope you enjoyed the fun intro to this video. I certainly had a lot of fun making it. And it was to introduce this project. Obviously, I'm not introducing the droids. If you know the Sphero products, you will know them well. What I'm actually introducing to you is the display stand that they're sitting on. Okay. Over the years, I've collected various computer components as different machines have died. And I had a couple of DVD-ROMs on hand that, frankly, I'm not going to use anymore. And even if they are working, I'm not even sure anymore. And just a few months ago, one chap gave me a burned-out laptop. And I'm thinking, what can I do with all that? And I'm looking at my R2-D2, because I only had him at the time I made this a couple of months ago. And I'm looking at my cosplay lightsaber and this old pad that my father had left me, which is so old that you can't update the operating system on it. And I thought, okay, I'm going to use the pad as a clock, and I'm going to put that with R2-D2, but I need to combine them somehow. And so I'm looking at this old laptop, and I'm thinking, I'd seen a project online. I'll put the link to it in the description below. But it was a project where foam was used, foam rubber sheets was used to make a display unit Star Wars style and with a slot that an iPad could slip into. This is just an old Samsung tablet. But I thought, well, there's got to be a way to put this together. So if we have a look here at the photos, you can see I pulled it off. I made a nice display. R2-D2 sits there really well. The lightsaber looks good on the 3D printed stand. And here's a more recent photo with BB-8 added. Okay, and he just sits on the side there in his own little charging pod, you know. It looks fantastic. The kids love it. So this is in my classroom at work. And kids come in like, wow, you got BB-8, you know. A lot of these young kids don't relate to R2-D2. I thought, I'm going to get BB-8. And I picked him up through Facebook Marketplace. Really cheap. The guy had bought it for his son a couple of years ago, along with the Force wristband, and his son used it once or twice and then quit, basically lost interest, and I managed to pick up both items almost new at a really good price, so they joined the fold, and just looks fantastic. The kids love it. You know, I play this game, if you know code.org, where the kids have got to put blocks of code together to make the character. It might be BB-8 actually, or it could be scrap from Ice Age or whatever it might be. And you've got to count out the tiles to decide how far the character's got to move forward, then turn and all of that. I've got a tiled floor in my classroom, so I run BB-8 or R2-D2 around the floor and get the kids to work together as a group, you know, getting the selected student to the robot. And that's great fun. The kids love it, you know. So it's been a great addition to my classroom, but okay, I'm sure you're wondering, how did I make this thing? And well, let me show you. I'm going to take these droids off. Okay, I've actually got them plugged into USB cables at the moment so they don't fall forwards, because it's a bit of a drop. Okay, so basically, I'll take the lightsaber off too. So basically what we've got here is the motherboard, okay? It's upside down compared to how it was orientated in the laptop. This is the main cooling unit for the CPU. I simply bent it vertically. It looks quite good like that, actually. I took some keys off the keyboard to mark out R2-D2, because originally this was just R2-D2. Okay. Although there's only one 2 on this keyboard, so I hope you don't mind, I used a Z. Anyway, this body here, this is actually the main shell, the main frame, if you like, out of a DVD-ROM. And I simply cut the side out of it, and I glued into the back this the case. Basically, it was just the case that my father had bought some years ago. I took off the central spiral, because it was a swing case, took off the lid and everything else, and just glued that into this frame so that it holds the pad there nicely, and it serves as a classroom clock. 3D printed stand. Had a little bit of trouble with my printing settings and it curled up in the corners, but it's still glued down well, so I'm not bothered by it. This is the actual ring actually from the back of the cover that allowed the cover of this pad to swing around. This is the actual DVD drawer. and I just put some signage board, like ripped plastic, in here just to fill in that hole, and covered it with non-slip matting so that R2-D2 could sit there without sliding around too much. And on the end, this is just the lid, you know, the pop-down, flip-down lid for the DVD-ROM. I just glued it, flipped it, reversed onto there just to close that up. These two steel pieces here, these are two right-angle brackets off a bed. That's all they are. They're just glued down to provide a base, solid base for the stand. And the bottom is literally the bottom of the laptop, but again, turned upside down. So you can imagine the motherboard would be screwed down here, and the DVD-ROM here, the hard drive here, here somewhere, I think, wherever else it might be. And I just put it face down, the motherboard glued on top, the tray glued on top, everything glued on top, basically. It's just glued. There's no screws. It's all just glued together with super glue and all-purpose glue. It was a really simple project to make, didn't take very long, made great use of old components. So while it isn't painted in Star Wars colors, it has the feel of Star Wars, which is what I was going for. And for the classroom situation, I wanted the components to be recognizable by the students. I wanted to be able to look at it and say, oh, that's a motherboard, or that's out of a DVD, or something like that. Or if they can't pick it, I can point it out to them, and you see their eyes light up. It's just brilliant. So that is my little Star Wars display project. And I have to say that it's worked really well. I like it. And I'm sure it's not finished. Things like this are never finished. I'm sure at some point there'll be additions or upgrades to come. So we'll see on that one. But for the meantime, R2-D2 sits there nicely. BB-8 can sit there nicely, or sometimes I sit him on the side. And I got myself a really nice display. It works really, really well. I'm so happy with it. And like I said before, it's a great use of recycling, you know.
So think about how you can recycle, repurpose old computer components, you know. Have a look at the Smugglers Room, okay? Brian there and his wife, they're doing a project where they're renovating their entire basement, like the interior of a smuggler's starship. You know, you can see bits of it inspired by the Millennium Falcon and things like that. But there's a lot of old components out of computers, VCRs, cameras, you name it. They call them greeblies, okay? But all these bits and pieces are kept and are used to greeblify their all the stuff they're making, you know? And it's absolutely brilliant that these things don't have to be dumped. They don't have to be incinerated. They can be reused, repurposed, painted up, glued onto something, screwed onto something, and you end up with a finished product that looks great. You know, this is not finished. I'm looking forward to the next stage. I'm actually hoping to get a couple of secondhand phones or pads, something like that, that's capable of running the Sphero software. Because, you know, the interface on that software looks brilliant. And I would like to have them just permanently running there as part of the display. Yeah, which means extra structure will be needed, obviously, to support them. So I'm looking forward to the next stage of this build, and I'm sure there'll be a video for that when the time comes. In the meantime, enjoy making stuff, being creative, and may the Force be with you. Bye-bye.